What's up there, all of you viewers? This is going to be an interesting video if you like tiger moths. Tiger moths are currently a subfamily of the Erebidae, the Arctinae. They used to be their own family, the Arctidae. But enough scientific names to the people that don't know them. It sounds like word vomit. I wanted to show you something else. This is currently one of my one of the best species that I'm breeding, believe it or not. And this is a Calimorpha species that came from Pakistan. It's called the Calimorpha principalis. Some old literature still calls them the Calindra principalis. And to be honest, they look quite different from Calimorpha. So it wouldn't surprise me if they were actually a different genus. Now let me tell you something about these animals that you're currently looking at. First of all, what I noticed is they grow very slowly. They grow so slowly that I thought they were hibernating, but this is not true. They're still eating, they're still feeding quite well, they're still active, so it's definitely not hibernation. It's just a very slowing species. I think I had these caterpillars since how long did I have them? I think maybe since June or July. So wow, I just counted in my head and they must be like 3 or 4 months old. And in all this time they've only grown a few centimeters. So it's definitely, they take it very easy. And now, why is this special? Why is what you're looking at special? And let me tell you why. Because first of all, barely anything is known about their life cycle in the wild. I would go as far as say that almost nothing is known about them. The adults can be locally very common. I've seen pictures of this species in the Himalaya and the surrounding regions in India and Pakistan. And some people who trap moths there, their moth sheet is completely covered with hundreds of specimens of the Calimorpha principalis. So it's probably not rare. It's a rather highland species, I believe. The eggs were found around 2,000 meter altitude in the mountains, so it comes from a mountainous area. Last of all, the livestock comes from Pakistan. That's unusual because it's very rare to get anything out of Pakistan because of legislations and protection measures that are in place. Pakistan is generally a very strict place, and so is India. And getting any live animals out there legally will be extremely hard and a challenge for any kind of entomologist, including me. So for me, this was really a special opportunity. And it seems they like to hide a lot. Here we see some shriveled up old leaves. But don't be fooled, here are caterpillars inside. See this? Here's one of the larvae. I think he has hidden to shed his skin. Or not. They just also really like to hide in objects, I've noticed. And what kind of bothers me is the adult moth is really big for a tiger moth. I've checked some online sources. And their wingspan is recorded to be around 7 to 9 centimeters. They don't reach 10 centimeters, but 7 to 9 centimeters in size is actually huge for a tiger moth, since the majority of species are kind of small. So this is definitely in the top 90% of big tiger moths. Despite their size, it surprises me how small the caterpillars are after all this time. And I was considering, is something wrong with them? And the answer is no. Honestly, they seem to grow perfectly fine on their own speed. They're eating well, they're growing well, they're shedding their skins. I have not lost a single individual. I started with 9 caterpillars and I still have 9 caterpillars after all these times, so I must be doing something completely right. But still, it's one interesting rearing, really. It's one very unusual rearing of very unusual species from a very unusual locality. And I can see the similarity to Calimorpha, but I also see a lot of differences in these caterpillars. And I think the final size of the caterpillar should be about this, big. I've raised some very big tiger moths, like the Arias galactina, if you check my older videos, and the Schema species, which is one of the very few tiger moths that actually gets over 10 centimeters in size, and all of them had quite big caterpillars, so I expect these guys have a long way to go. If they grow like 2 or 3 centimeters in 3 to 4 months time, imagine how long it will take to rear them to adulthood. Tips are welcome. This is completely new. It's completely novel. It's a new type of rearing. I don't think anybody has raised this species before, to be honest. So it's really an experiment, a trial and error kind of thing. But stay tuned for their development. I will keep posting them once in a while. Thank you all for watching.